Tic paralysis treatment begins by administering some sedation to assist with their breathing, followed by placement of an IV catheter to allow IV fluids, followed by an infusion of the antitoxin. This has to be monitored very closely by a nurse. The following treatment after this relies on intensive nursing care, close respiratory monitoring, and also a tic clip and bath. This means a total shave of the patient. And the reason we do this is up to 10% of patients have a second tic on them. So it's essential that we find this tic, otherwise they're going to continue to deteriorate. Some of our more critical patients who have further issues with their breathing require oxygen support, while others may need mechanical ventilation and life support to survive. I mean this when I say these tic patients are very unpredictable. Because of their ability or lack of ability of esophageal function, it means that these patients have the risk of regurgitation. And then they can inhale this vomit into their airways, ending up with a really nasty aspiration pneumonia. This can turn a stable tic patient into a life-threatening situation within seconds. So it's essential that we look forward to how we can prevent this from happening. Now, tic prevention is essential, and the good news is this tic paralysis, it is preventable, and this is through the use of tic prevention products, the most common being NexGard and Bravecto. Have a chat to your vet about which product is going to work for your pet. The other essential part is checking your pet daily for any evidence of ticks on their fur or coat. It's also important that even if your pet is indoors only or only stays in your backyard, that you consider tick prevention. This is because even if your cat escapes that one time, they can still suffer from tick paralysis. So it's really important to make sure they're on prevention. So as always, again, keep up to date with prevention and know the signs to protect your pet.